In this session, we will make a beginning in understanding the topic economic development. Economic development can be measured. How can countries or states be compared? We can do it by using some selected development indicators. Income is the most common method for measuring development. However, the income method has several weaknesses. Hence, we need to use other indicators like quality of life and environmental sustainability. We all have aspirations or desires about what we would like to do and how we would like to live. Different people have different aspirations. Why do different persons have different notions of development? Because life situations of persons are different. Development goals of a girl from a rich urban family will be surely different from a farmer in Rajasthan. It is because their situations, lifestyle, and status are very different from each other. One common thing what people desire are regular work, better wages, and decent price for their products. In other words, people want more income. Money or material things that we can buy with it is one factor on which our life depends. However, the quality of our life also depends on non-material things such as equal treatment, freedom, security, and respect for others. These goals cannot be measured, but much important. For development, people look at a mix of goals like material as well as non-material things. The developmental goals are not only about better income, but also about other important things in life. Similarly, we have ideas about what a country should be like. It is very important to keep in mind that different persons could have different as well as conflicting notions of a country's development. How to compare different countries or states? You may have heard some countries are generally called developed and others underdeveloped. When we compare different things, they could have similarities as well as differences. To compare countries, their income is considered to be one of the most important attributes. Countries with higher income are more developed than others with less income. As different countries have different populations, comparing total income will not tell us what an average person earns. So we compare the average income of countries. Average income is the total income of the country divided by its total population. It is also called per capita income. Average income is equal to total income of country divided by total population of country. In World Development Reports brought out by the World Bank, per capita income is used in classifying countries. Countries with per capita income of US dollar 12,056 and above per annum in 2017 are called rich countries. Whereas countries with per capita income of US dollar 955 or less are called low income countries. India comes in the category of low middle income countries. Besides size of per capita income, what other property of income is important in comparing two or more societies? Not only per capita income, but also homogeneity or equity of performance should be reflected while comparing two or more societies. If a society has higher per capita income, but much of its income is with a small group, then it cannot reflect the development of the society. While averages are useful for comparison, they also hide disparities because it does not tell us how this income is distributed among people. As we have seen, people's desires are regular work, better wages, and decent price for their crops or other products that they produce. In other words, they want more income. Besides seeking more income, one way or the other, people also seek things like equal treatment, freedom, security, and respect of others. They hate discrimination. All these are important goals. When we think of a nation or a region, besides average income, public facilities are equally significant attributes. If you look at the per capita income of the states like Maharashtra, Bihar and Kerala, Maharashtra has the highest per capita income and Bihar is at the bottom. Goa has the highest per capita income among all the Indian states. So if per capita income were to be used as the measure of development, Maharashtra will be considered the most developed and Bihar the least developed state. In Kerala, out of 1,000 children born, 12 died before completing 1 year of age. But in Maharashtra, the proportion of children dying within 1 year of birth is 25, which is more than double the number in Kerala. That means the infant mortality rate is high in Maharashtra. The average person in Maharashtra has more income than the average person in Kerala, but lags behind in many other crucial areas. The infant mortality rate is highest in Madhya Pradesh, whereas it is lowest in Kerala. Bihar has the highest birth rate. So income by itself is not a completely adequate indicator of material goods and services that citizens are able to use. For example, normally our money cannot buy us a pollution-free environment. Our money may not be able to protect us from infectious diseases. There are many things that are not easily measured, but they mean a lot to our lives. Very often these things are ignored. For many of the important things in life, the best and the cheapest way is to provide these goods and services collectively. That means public facilities are services provided by the government to its citizens. Some of the important public facilities include infrastructure, sanitation, public transport, healthcare, water, etc. These facilities naturally improve our dignity. Kerala has a low infant mortality rate because it has adequate provision of basic health and educational facilities. Over the past 10 decades or so, health and education indicators are widely used along with income as a measure of development. For instance, Human Development Report published by UNDP compares countries based on the educational levels of the people, their health status, and per capita income. HDI stands for Human Development Index. Many components like life expectancy, literacy rate, gross national income, etc. are used in calculating HDI. The Human Development Index is a statistic composite index of life expectancy. A country scores a higher HDI when the lifespan is higher, the education level is higher, and the gross national income or GNI per capita is higher. India's HDI value for 2019 is 0.645, which put India in the medium human development category. In Human Development Index 2020, India has been positioned at 131 out of 181 countries and territories. A small country in our neighborhood, Sri Lanka, is much ahead of India in all this respect. Sustainability of development. If a country is quite developed, we would certainly like this level of development to go up further or at least be maintained for future generations. Sustainable development is defined as development that meets the needs of the present without compromising the ability of future generations. It means an approach to developing or growing by using available resources in a way that allows people to renew or continue to exist for others. In other words, the materials and resources that we use for our growth and development should be useful for the future generation also. It is nothing but using available resources judiciously without compromising the need of the present and future generations. Using recycled materials or renewable resources is an example of sustainable development. Scientists have been warning that the present type and levels of development are not sustainable. Some of the examples are overuse of groundwater and exhaustion of natural resources. Overuse of groundwater by the present generation could result in drying up of streams and lakes apart from causing induced pollution. Exhaustion of natural resources by us results in soil degradation, water shortages, biodiversity loss, damage to ecosystem and global warming. However, we can say that what cannot be measured is also important. The developmental goals are not only about better income, but also about other important things like freedom and dignity of life. So, quality of life and environmental sustainability are also important to measure economic development.